Nobody's going to give you anything. They're still not giving
you. Yo, CPA Strength here with another video. I don't know why I was listening. This video is brought to you by Motivational Speaking and Gangster Rap. Formal Friday, the most jacked CPA you might know. What is this? This is Eric Thomas. I don't know. What's he saying?
Here's the challenge, though. I asked myself when I read that story. That's what's on the surface. I read it, and I started asking myself, E.T., what's the difference between a gazelle and what's the difference between a lion?
One's predator, one's prey.
I know that they're wired different, but what's the difference? And what I discovered is that the gazelle is running from something.
Oh. Okay, then.
The gazelle is running from...
I don't know, I just felt like doing that for this video. I don't know why. I've been listening to motivational speaking for like the past couple hours. And so I just had my laptop over here. And I just, you know, I got my camera out. I got this board ready for what we're doing today and all this stuff. And, you know, hit record on the camera bowl. Everything got ready and I've been playing this for 2 hours. So that was the next thing that came on. I don't know, I just thought that'd be fun. Like, what is, like, the next thing? And it was, what was it? What's the difference between a gazelle and a lion? Because the gazelle's running from something? I don't know. Anyways. Yeah, I've been listening to a lot of motivational speaking this morning. And, of course, the gangster rap. Or like, JD, why do you listen to this trap? Why do you put this trash music in the middle of it? Because it motivates me. Because I love it. Because it is me. Because I think the first tape I ever bought was Two Live Crew tape, a rap tape. They're from down here in South Florida. And it's like, you know, another License to Ill by Beastie Boys, a rap tape. That's who I am. I love rap. I love trap music. I love shoot 'em up, bang bang, gangster rap. All right, it's just what it is. It's me. And I'll tell you what. There's something that I'm better than every single one of you watching this right now. I am a better Jonathan Dorn than anybody else in this world. Get that? So I'm just gonna keep doing me, baby. Yeah. Anyways, this is Accounting for Beginners number 91. 91, hey! 91. Can you believe we made 91? Bro, I remember making my first 5. Oh my god. Anyways, so there's 91. So you're like, did you do 90 other videos on accounting for beginners? Yeah, bro. So up here's the playlist. Best playlist in the world. You get all the videos. Now, this is like, what is the best? What is the best? You know, and it's a good question. I'm trying to be the best in the world at something. So it's like, you know, you're trying to pass a class, you're trying to learn accounting, you're like, what's the best mapping system? What's the best mnemonic? What's the best way? You know, I like DCA Learn. It's just kind of what I learned also. I've gotten, hundreds of thousands of different variations of the DCA Learn. Like, in the comment sections, I use this, I like this. They're all good. What I'm saying is they're all good, okay? It's like pizza. It's like deep dish or New York thin. You know, it's all good, okay? You know, what do you like, pepperonis or olives or both? Or it's all good. It's however, you know, however you're eating that pizza, right, baby? So, I use DCA Learn, and what I was getting at is I've read a comment that I actually forget now what he said he uses. Someone did something because I have two E's here and he got confused whether it's an expense or an equity, which, yeah, I agree. But I've just started with this, and it's so ingrained, and I don't even really use like this anymore, is what I'm getting at. So some other popular ones is Dade Clur, I've seen, DC Dior. Then over here, it's like I use equity right here for the lore. I use equity right here. But then, you know, some other people have, you know, change some of the letterings around. I guess I just noticed right now they all start with D. So at least everyone can always remember that that's debit, I guess. I don't know. I just saw that right now. I have a very weird brain. I'm weird, weird, weird. I actually got a comment. So it's a CPA strength. You're weird as fuck. I'm like, thank you very much. Anyways, so I use equity. Other people place capital. Other people put owner's equity. What I'm saying is I'm not concerned about which way, what mnemonic or mapping device you use. I'm not even concerned if you even use a mapping device. I really don't care. Do I care what you call, if you call it equity, owner's equity, or capital? No. It's basically what the owner has invested in the business. It's, or you could see, I kind of like to see as, how, what I think this, these are, is assets equal liabilities plus equity. That's the balance sheet. Right, and so you have assets. So you have a truck, right? You have a truck here. Who owns the truck? Do you owe the truck to somebody else, or does the company own it? Owe or own? Do you owe, or do you own it? Right. So that's what I that's all this is. Do you what part of the assets do you own or not? So I don't care how you label it. What's the best, right? What's the best? It's however you can get to a debit over here, a debit on the left, and a credit on the right. I just thought I'd construct like what I think's important, and how you get there, I don't really care how you get there. Like, look, you got to work. Did you take the? You got to the workplace bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. I don't care if you drove your car. I don't care if you took the subway. I don't care if you took a scooter. I don't care if you hitchhiked. I don't care how you got here. You're just here on time, and you're bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. Conversely, I just came up with that analogy. I'm a spizzle. So I don't care how you put it, fill in these 8 different boxes. I just want you to fill in these 8 boxes. The most important thing, the most important thing, everything's either going to be a debit or a credit. So left or right. So that's why I personally like to segregate. That's not racist, is it? Anyways, I like to segregate the D and the C because that's debit and credit, because that's like half of it. Left and the right. Then I don't care how or when. Basically, you have 3 items. You have 3 items that if they're increasing their debits. Then you have 3 items if they're increasing, they're gonna be credits. So you can mix match them all the way. See, Dade Clur has the same, it's asset draw expense. See, they have debit and credit, but But I like to just get that out of the way first, like its own thing. Because it is, to me, it's its own thing. It's a debit and credit. But I see the merit in this and the Dave Clutter because you have them separated. I kind of am looking at this one now and I'm kind of liking this Dave Clutter too. Because over here you have your debits. And then over here you have your credits when they're both going up. So I kind of like this one too. It has the assets here. Has the assets top left, and then it has the liabilities and equity. See, I have the asset and the liabilities and equity right there. So I have the balance sheet. If you use the DC deal, so this is a EAL. Oh, I'm sorry. Draw expense assets. So the DC dealer. Draw expense asset. And then over LOR, liabilities, owner equity revenue. So the same over here, right? The revenue will go here. What I don't like about this one, my personal preference, but if you like it, you like it. This one, it mixes up, see, here's the income statement on this one, and then the balance sheet is here, and then this is the other side of that. So see, that's why I don't really like the difference. That's why I personally like DC Adler. Did this video even make any sense? Did this video help anyone? I hope it helped somebody, because that is the main focus of my videos when I make one every morning. How many people can this help? Can this help somebody? Is this gonna help somebody? So I hope this helps somebody, I really do. Let's see if we can summarize in the last couple minutes that I have. What was I thinking? Because I always get, I use this or I use this. It really doesn't matter. Oh, I know what I can summarize. I Google searched myself the other day just to see what pops up. And it's kind of amazing how big I'm getting now. And the stuff, if you would have searched for me 20 years ago, that would have popped up, or when the internet started, I've just flooded it with more different stuff for my name. Anywho, I said I was gonna summarize. What are you gonna summarize? But they're like, how can I trust CPA Strength? How can I trust it? Can I trust him? That was a question on Reddit I seen. Hey, this guy's CPA Strength. Does anybody know he has a basic accounting series on YouTube? Can I trust him? Well, yeah, because I just teach the basics. All I'm teaching is, so it's like the DC Adler. I don't even want to get caught up in that. You know, this is the basics of accounting. I just want you to know debit or credit. Debit is left, credit is right. I want you to know on the left-hand side, which is also the debit side, you would have three different accounts in the positive form: asset, draw, and expense. On the right side, also the credit side, you would have three different accounts, main accounts, whatever, that if they go up, they go on, if they're increasing, they go on the right side, which is also the credit side. Those three accounts are liability, equity, and revenue. So that is a summary. I don't care how you get there. I want you to stop forgetting about all the rules in your head, how you get there. I just want you to write that on your paper every single morning. And then I'm telling you, after a year or something, you just put a line. You'll just put a line through this. And then, you know, you just see it in your head. But anyways, I love this. Till next time, this is CP.